Well, what my main goal is for deaf Ontarians to be able to understand and to be able to stay up to date with all of the new information. And as well, there's a lot of information and it is changing every day, hour by hour, day by day.
Well, good afternoon.
He is the man behind the premier. Literally. Christopher Delage is the American Sign Language interpreter you see for the provincial government updates at Queen's Park. And Kim Peltier is usually the deaf interpreter you see during medical updates. Both work as a team at Queen's Park to make press conferences accessible.
The difference between a deaf interpreter and a hearing interpreter is that deaf interpreters grew up deaf and their first language is ASL. And so they have a much stronger control over the language. And whereas I'm a hearing interpreter and I didn't learn sign language until I was about 10 years old.
Both have received praise from the community over social media for their daily work, especially drawing attention for their expressiveness.
Facial expressions are part of deaf culture. We use it as, it's part of the grammar in ASL. So facial expressions are something that we have to use to make sure people are understanding our tone. Yes, there's a lot of social media attention on me. And that's all great, but what's really important is that a lot of people are starting to see accessibility, and they're seeing accessibility on a provincial stage.
And while they both appreciate the accolades, they want to draw attention to the fact that sign language is just that, a language, and that they are providing a serious service for those who are deaf.
It is a door that has been opened for the deaf community and also a door for society to see and create more awareness to see what's happening. So maybe it's going to create more accessibility and more flexibility for the deaf community and for deaf people to be included. And that is amazing.
Interestingly, because COVID-19 is a new virus, a new sign had to be created to communicate about it.
COVID-19? Is a new sign, and it was developed somewhere in Europe with a virus. This is, for example, what a virus looks like, and then an organism. So you can see on a virus, you actually see kind of the spikes that are around it.
To help with sign language is Christopher.
And it's not just the public who are noticing. Today, Christopher was surprised to receive thanks from Premier Ford during his daily update.
I told him today how many comments and emails and phone calls I get about you. My friend, you're a champion, you're a rock star, helping people in the deaf community.
And while they both say that their workload and their responsibility for interpreting the correct messages during this time is heavier than ever, they do hope that the attention that they are getting brings more awareness to the needs for the deaf and to sign language. At Queen's Park, Audra Brown, City News.